fishing involves sending out bait, mostly through email, to a large number of people, hoping some users will bite by sending usernames, passwords, and even credit card information. When clicking a link in a phishing email, the user is brought to a web page that looks and feels like a real banking site, the real PayPal site, the real eBay site, the real Facebook site, the real LinkedIn site, and much more. Therefore, the user feels safe and secure in entering sensitive information, which goes directly to the attacker. Furthermore, simply visiting these sites could install malware on a victim machine. This is like a fisherman who casts his rod into the water, hoping to lure some fish with bait, as opposed to the fisherman who gets dinner. The fisher gets network access, PII, personally identifiable information, and is able to install malware for subsequent damage and access. Spear phishing takes phishing to a whole new level by targeting specific users of a specific company instead of just random email addresses that may or may not be valid. When you go after the big fish of a company, like anyone that has a title beginning with a C and ending with an O, that's taking spear phishing to a whole new level, and it's called whaling. So sending an email to random Gmail accounts, bob1@gmail.com, bob2@gmail.com, bob3@gmail.com, would be considered phishing. Sending emails to specific users of a company, alice@company.org, eve@company.org, harry@company.org, would be considered spear phishing. Finally, sending emails to the bigwigs at a company, CEO@company.org, theboss@company.org, CISO@company.org, that would be considered whaling. Farming is the hijacking of a legitimate website's IP address and/or domain name. It redirects unsuspecting users to a fake site and collects information that users enter, like passwords, banking information, and other PII. A watering hole is a computer attack strategy in which the victim is in a particular group, whether it's an organization, an industry, or a region. In this attack, the hacker guesses or observes which websites the group often uses. And then the hacker infects one or more of those sites with malware. Eventually, some member of the targeted group gets infected. Relying on websites that the group trusts makes the strategy efficient, even with groups that are resistant to the different forms of phishing. And of course, probably the biggest type of malware in the news today, ransomware, which locks and encrypts a device until a ransom fee is paid. Scare tactics include threatening the users that if they don't pay by a certain amount of time, files will start to be deleted. The general recommendation is not to pay the ransom. It encourages the adversaries to continue this type of extortion. It funds their future activities, and it doesn't even guarantee that you will get a decryption key, or even that the decryption key you get will work. The best way to be safe is to not click on any unknown links and to keep a good set of backups that you can bring back and restore from instead of paying the ransom